curious. How do you drink your morning coffee? From a capsule machine, like me? Well, then you belong to the 60% of households in Switzerland that buy coffee capsules. And if you live in France, it is even 70% of households. And have you ever started to think about the amount of waste that your coffee consumption creates? I would like to tell you my story. My name is Caroline. I'm a food technologist working in the field of research and development. And when I started to work for the coffee industry almost 10 years ago as a project manager, my very first project was to create the beverages for a Dolce Gusto compatible capsule that my company launched during that time. But my job was not only to create the beverages, from coffee to cappuccino, latte macchiato, hot chocolate, but also to test the capsule's functionality, to help industrialize the capsule, and later on, even to improve the capsule itself. And even if this was a very interesting project where I really learned a lot and every day, the capsule's weight without any filling was about 5 grams. That means that the amount of plastic for every capsule was close to the amount of coffee powder that you fill inside. So to be honest, on a certain point, standing in a hall full of injection molding plants, I started to think about the amount of waste that is created to enjoy one single cup of coffee or hot chocolate or chai tea latte. Then, in 2017, I received a new task. I was asked to create a new capsule, but without any capsule around. How does that sound to you? Creating a capsule without a capsule. So to be honest, to me, once I realized that this wasn't a joke, it felt first like a mission impossible. But I also realized that this was a great opportunity and a lot of things seem impossible until you start working on it. So, on a blank piece of paper, we started to research on natural materials, carbohydrates, proteins, fats, and we realized that we were looking for a material able to form a shell around freshly roasted coffee, and thus being able to stabilize a roasted coffee compact so that it will be stable enough to bring it to all your homes. And the material being able to brew a good cup of espresso and lungo coffee. Why? So that it just tastes great. And we will hopefully convince you to switch your coffee capsule system in the future. So off we went with a very small but passionate and interdisciplinary team. We searched and searched, and we found our natural material. We discovered alginate. Alginate that derives from brown algae, which grow, in our case, in the coastal regions of Brittany in France. And this very simple but genius material turned the page. And here's why in 5 key points. Number one, alginate coats very easy into a stable and taste-neutral shell. At room temperature, without heating up the solution, at low concentrations, and thanks to just a very few other plant-based ingredients like cellulose fibers. Number two, our alginate, and alginates in general, come with a natural oxygen barrier. So that means that our shell is able to protect the freshly roasted coffee in the inside from oxidation, what is pretty convenient when your goal is to develop a delicious cup of coffee and to avoid the rapid development of any stale coffee taste. Number three, our alginate coating, by bringing it into contact with a calcium solution, turns water insoluble. So why is that important, being water insoluble? Well, I can tell you, for a coffee beverage developer, this is pretty smart. Because remember, we want to have that delicious cup of coffee, so we don't want to have any alginate to end up in there, right? Number four, the alginate coating is very easy to compost. It composts in just a few weeks to nothing else but soil. And see here some pictures from my own garden. Day 8, you still see some product. Day 13, and obviously any kind of worm or millipede or snail, they all love this coffee alginate menu. And number 5, our alginate coating is non-sticky. So what I described before, bringing the alginate into contact with the calcium solution, is another win-win situation for us. And this is something that I would like to show you here on stage. So I have here the pressed coffee compact, and I think not everybody will see it, but just in a second. I start coating now the coffee ball. I strip a little bit off the alginate. And now I drop it in a second step into this calcium solution. And just in that instant, a gel was formed. And this gel is not just water insoluble, but also non-sticky. And who wants? You? Just try. So why is that important, having a non-sticky shell? Well, ask the engineering and operations team at work. Having a non-sticky shell makes the handling and the drying of that coating very easy, so that the alginate won't stick to all the components of your industrial line. Well, now you enjoyed, let's say, a short deep dive into my everyday work, and hopefully you now understand why alginate was just a perfect match for us. Nevertheless, in the very beginning, we asked ourselves if our customers would really accept an alginate shell around coffee, deriving from algae. But I can tell you, the more we were reading about alginates, but also algae, the more convinced we became that we have just taken the right path. Because we learned that microalgae made it possible for life on Earth to develop. Why? Because they were here before everything else, turning CO2 into oxygen, and so creating our atmosphere. Because when you now take a deep breath, so please just follow me, taking one deep inhalation. Just 50% of the oxygen that you just inhaled derived from algae. Why? Because they grow just everywhere, and as I learned, even on our shoes. And they have the potential to save our planet from the rising CO2 emissions. So isn't that amazing, and isn't that truly sustainable? Sorry. So, coming to the end of my talk, I would like to take you back to the question of why. Maybe you have even asked yourself, why do we need a sustainable solution for portioned coffee? Why don't we use just coffee beans? The truth is, because we won't stop this trend. Coffee capsules exist now for over 30 years. Actually, they were launched in the year of 1986, which is the year where I was born. And they are still growing in numbers year by year. Why? Because they are just too convenient to abandon them from our everyday life. But having a natural alternative to 100,000 tons of coffee capsule waste every year worldwide, we are now able to turn the page. With this small, sustainable plant-based solution that we have just developed. And now, one more question to you. What would you like to change for the better by using natural resources instead of petroleum-based ones? Please just think about it, at least for our future generations. And now, thank you.